Our top story tonight. Four innocent people killed, an entire law enforcement agency on edge, a one-man terror crusade and California's biggest ever manhunt. That was the week of misery that Christopher Dorner inflicted on Los Angeles and its surrounds. Tonight, it's believed Dorner is dead following a cabin fire in the mountains and a violent police gunfight. 10's US correspondent Daniel Sutton is near Big Bear in California. Dan, are police sure they got their man?
Well, Matt, in the past few hours, they have confirmed that charred human remains have been found in a cabin a few kilometres up the road from where we are right now. That road is still closed. Forensic examiners are still going over that cabin. It's not confirmed that it's Christopher Dorner, but it's all but. It's believed he died in a raging inferno in that building. It's where he took refuge during a firefight, and that was against the law enforcement brothers and sisters he used to work alongside.
The final battle for a killer bent on revenge. After 6 days on the run, Christopher Dorner was surrounded, and this time his firepower was no match for dozens of former colleagues closing in.
Guys down!
In the gunfire, a sheriff's deputy was shot dead, another was injured.
Has there been any communication between negotiators and the man inside this house?
I'm not aware of any negotiators that are on scene.
Smoke bombs were used as cover to remove the deputies from harm's way. Then, as police used equipment to demolish the cabin, a final single gunshot, then fire.
After the fire began, there has been no exchange of gunfire since then.
Within minutes, the building was a raging inferno. Officers swarmed the Big Bear ski resort area when a man matching Dorner's description stole a white ute. Schools and tourist accommodation were locked down. Worried families were told they couldn't go home.
Mom's up there crying, you know, worried about her baby.
Locals had come to know the violent fugitive was out there. All of California and the world had.
Of course he knows what he's doing, and we trained him.
The massive manhunt was launched last week after Dorner killed a former LAPD captain's daughter and her fiancé. He was furious at being sacked from the force 5 years ago, so drew up a chilling manifesto promising to bring warfare to other officers and their families. He succeeded four times. A formal ID will be needed to confirm it is Dorner inside that burnt-out cabin, but that process will begin tomorrow. For now, police are taking a well-earned rest.
I want to thank them for their bravery. I want to thank all of the law enforcement.
A brotherhood tonight breathing a sigh of relief after a week of watching their back.
And Dan, he came across some civilians today. What did he do to them?
Well, there's been a lot of inquiries as to where he has been staying. There's been an intensive search in this area. It turns out he may have been hiding out in another cabin about 40 kilometres further up the road. Well, two cleaners went into that cabin today and surprised him. He tied them up and then stole their car, but didn't hurt them. And that is not really that surprising, considering his stated targets have been law enforcement officers and their families. He was then spotted in that car. It's believed he carjacked another vehicle. That's when he was engaged by law enforcement officers and this firefight began, Matt.
Quite extraordinary. And Dan, what happens now?
Well, forensic teams are still at the house down the road. They will have to confirm with scientific tests whether or not this is the body of Christopher Dorner. That may take some days, possibly even weeks. In the meantime, the LAPD says it will continue the protective details they've had going on surrounding his 50 or so targets that he mentioned in his rambling manifesto. But here up in the mountains near Big Bear, the search is well and truly over.
Dan Sutton in California, thanks for the update.